Hi, my name is James Messer, and you're watching my CompTIA A+ certification training course. Before we get into the description of the course, let me give you a little background of myself and why I created this course. I've been in the industry about 25 years now, and I have experience from using not just personal computers, but all the way up to mainframes and supercomputers as well. It's something that I've dedicated my life to doing, and I always find technology is something where you can always learn something a little bit more than what you know already. I've also authored a number of training courses, not just A+ training courses, but technology courses in general. They include security and networking and Linux and Microsoft and much more as well. I do have my A+ certification along with my Network Plus, my Security Plus, and also a number of other certifications as well. You may have seen training courses before that focus on long chapters of information. There may be an hour or 90 minutes of information, but I designed this course with small little bites of information. So you should be able to focus on a particular topic, watch that video, and then you can go do something else, or you can simply watch the next video. You now get to decide how much time you want to spend at any particular point to get the information that you need. I created these videos because there was not a lot of high-quality training information available on the internet. There are a lot of different training sites out there. Some are free, some are not. Some are okay quality, some are definitely not in okay quality. There was not a lot of detail and focus put into creating quality information that could also be made freely available on the internet. And since my background deals not only with technology, but also technology training, I was able to combine those things together and create this course. When I started building this course, I didn't have any particular time frame in mind. There wasn't any particular constraints associated with this. It's the internet. I can build a video, I can put them out there, and you can watch them. So I can create as many videos as we need with however long it takes to get through the content. And that's my main goal, is to provide as much information as possible so that someone watching this course would be able to use this in order to get their technical certification. So you may look at all these videos and wonder, why are these available for free? Is there some type of catch involved? And there isn't. I put every video online. You can watch every minute of every video for absolutely free. I don't just put a couple of videos online or a couple of minutes of every video. Every single minute of every single video is online and available for you to stream for absolutely free. The only thing you might consider to be a catch would be that you can only watch them for free online. If you'd like to take these videos with you when you are not connected to the internet, then I have them available for sale. And if you'd like to watch them when you're on a plane, or you'd like to listen to the MP3 files when you're in a car, I can make those available for you. Just go to the website and you can download those immediately, and I'll send you a package of DVD-ROMs with all of that content on them. Purchasing the videos is a great way to support the site, and watching the videos online is also a great way to support the site, and I've indexed the entire set of videos for every training class. You can find them all on my website at professormesser.com. If you've never looked into the CompTIA A+, Network Plus, Security Plus, and any of their other certifications, this may be relatively new to you. CompTIA stands for the Computing Technology Industry Association. It is a very large consortium of many different organizations that include resellers of IT equipment, distributors, manufacturers, training centers, and they've all gotten together to provide these certifications. It used to be that these certifications were very specific to a manufacturer. You could get an IBM certification, a Compaq certification, you could get an Acer certification, but you had to go to every single manufacturer to get those. To streamline the process a bit, especially for distributors and manufacturers and everyone else, you now have one organization that handles these very high-end certifications. So now you can go to CompTIA and get an A+ certification that's then recognized by all of these other organizations. Another benefit of these CompTIA certifications is that they are recognized all over the world. You can go to 100 different countries around the world and get your A+ certification. In fact, there's many different languages that you can use. If you are trying to find a Spanish-speaking, English-speaking, a German version of the language, you can visit CompTIA's website at CompTIA.org and find out what versions of what tests might be available in your country. If you're watching this certification course, then you're probably interested in the CompTIA A+ certification. And that makes sense. It's one of the most popular certifications that you will find in the world. And that's probably because it's a great entry-level certification. If you're trying to start in IT or learn more about technology, the A+ is a very, very common place to start. It allows you to get into your first job or build up from your existing position into a higher level position. And many organizations will require that you have some type of certification. And very often they're mentioning the A+ certification specifically. So it makes sense that this would be a very good place to start. And of course, with most certifications, you're also learning. One of the nice parts about the A+ certification is that you learn a lot of information across a very broad series of topics. And as you get into learning more about the A+ cert and looking at the requirements that you need to pass the exam, you'll notice that you're learning everything from operating systems to hardware to security to networking. To get the CompTIA A+ certification, you need to pass two separate exams. One exam is the 220-801. The 220-801 includes topics of PC hardware, networking, laptops, printers, and operational procedures. There are 90 questions maximum on the exam. You may be asked fewer than 90 questions, but you can expect a maximum of 90. And you'll notice the passing score is 675. This is on a scale of 900. Now, CompTIA doesn't say what their scale really means. They don't give a lot of information about that, but what we've seemed to find is that each question is worth a different number of points. So we really can't apply a percentage passing score to this. We really have to keep in mind that every exam question may be worth a different amount, and you have to make sure you get enough to reach at least 675 points to pass the 220-801 exam. The 220-802 exam covers these topics: operating systems, security, mobile devices, and troubleshooting. And again, you'll get a maximum of 90 questions, but you have to do a little bit better on this exam. You have to get at least a 700 score on a total of 900 possible points. Both the 220-801 and the 220-802 exam both use a large number of multiple choice questions. So you'll be asked a question and you'll need to choose from a predefined list of answers. Usually it is a single answer you're looking for, but some questions may ask you for multiple answers. And in those cases, it will tell you how many answers to expect. You should answer two or three of the different options at the bottom. CompTIA also includes performance-based questions on their exam. These performance-based questions may ask you to perform a task, or it may require that you match like information together. These particular questions will require that you take all of this knowledge that you've learned and you start applying it immediately. If you're asked to perform a function at the command line, you need to know exactly what to type in and what options to include to make that command work properly. Before you take the exam, it would be a good idea to know exactly what's expected of you. And CompTIA makes a very comprehensive set of exam requirements on their website. You can find that at CompTIA.org. I've designed my videos to match these exam requirements, so you should be able to look through CompTIA's exam requirements, and you'll notice that my videos are numbered exactly the same way. That should make it very easy for you to find the information you're looking for. I've also got a series of frequently asked questions on my website. You can find that at professormesser.com/FAQ, and there's a lot of other resources on the website for you to take advantage of as well. Before you begin the examination, perhaps even before you schedule the examination, you might want to see what testing locations are available in your area. Not all testing sites are exactly the same. There are certain standards that they must apply to, but you'll find that some have very small rooms, others have very large rooms, and you're going to want to find the testing center that fits right with your method of test taking. Don't go into a test taking place before you've ever seen it. You may be surprised at what you find when you walk in the door. And of course, make sure that you eat well and sleep well the night before. You want to go into that exam with the best possible opportunity to do well. When you finally get to a point where you've started the exam, an important thing to do is to relax as much as possible. I get very nervous when I'm ready to take exams. It usually takes me 5 to 10 minutes to settle down once the exam is started, and then I get into the right frame of mind to be able to take that exam. But there are things going on in the testing center that might also be a problem. If things are noisy outside the testing room or the environment is too hot or too cold, make sure you let the testing center know right then that there's a problem. Don't wait until you've gotten all the way through the exam before you inform them that there was an issue while you were taking the exam. You also want to think about how much time it takes to answer these questions. If you aren't quite sure of a particular answer, you can check it with a mark setting that allows you to come back to it later. You can always come back to any of the questions that you've taken during the exam. So if you aren't 100% sure, maybe you mark it as one that you want to review later on. And maybe the ones that you know absolutely certain that you don't have to go back, you can leave those blank. That way at the end, you can always go back through everything that you've marked before and be as efficient as possible at double checking those. One of the things I like to do is whether I've marked a question or not, before I'm finally ready to do that submit button at the very end, I go through every single question one more time. And I do that because there may be questions that I thought were 100% right early on in the exam that another question jogged my memory about and made me realize that that question was actually not correct. So by going through one final time, you may be able to get one or two questions set absolutely correctly so that when you hit the submit button, you'll have the best possible score. When you hit the submit button at the end of the exam, you'll be informed immediately on the screen whether you passed or whether you failed. In both of those cases, there will be a printout waiting for you that will either give you the information about the passing score, or it will give you information about what topics you did well on and which ones you did not do well on. And you can use that information to help study for the next test-taking scenario. If you study right away, you can take the exam immediately. You can take that retake without any delay at all between that first exam and the second exam. If you fail the second exam, you have to wait at least 14 days for the third attempt on that particular exam. One important consideration is that you have to pay every time. There are no free retakes available, so make sure that you're ready to go the instant you walk into that testing center. Once you pass your A+ certification, that certification is valid for 3 years. This is based on a standard from the ANSI ISO IEC 17024 that says that certification exams to have this standardization must be regularly renewed. Now, this doesn't mean that you have to take the exam every 3 years. In fact, I would imagine that most people will not be taking their exam every 3 years. The CompTIA A+, Network Plus, Security Plus, and CASP exams all comply with an international standard called the ANSI ISO IEC 17024. This standard says that certifications can't exist permanently. They have to be regularly renewed in order to stay current. The way that CompTIA allows for this constant renewal is through either continuing education units or by taking higher level certifications that will then renew your A+ certification. If you don't renew, your certification will expire after 3 years. Most people are not going to take the test after a 3-year period, although that's certainly something you can do. Usually you're not stopping with the A+ certification, you're working towards other certs. And I would imagine that most people will simply take the Network Plus certification, or perhaps even certifications from other third-party companies. If you'd like to know more about your options for renewing and keeping your certification current, you can visit CompTIA's website for all of the details. I put together a number of resources that can help you with your A+ studies on ProfessorMesser.com. And the first, of course, is this entire library of videos. They're absolutely free. They're completely indexed. You can visit the website for the entire list of all of my training courses. I also have message boards available. You can communicate back and forth with the folks there and leave messages and reply to other people's questions that they might have. There's a registration you have to go through, but those are also still free and available. I don't have any restricted areas or private sections. Everything is completely open and available for you. I also have a 24/7 real-time chat at the bottom of the Professor Messer website where you can get instant messages and instant feedback for questions that you might have. And I also have a wiki available at professormesser.com/wiki. And I hope you take advantage of those resources and contribute if you happen to have information that you think might help. I hope you find that these videos will assist you at getting your A+ certification, and I hope to see you on the website. Thanks for watching, and good studies.